Can you tell which is which? One is the new DJI Mavic Air and the other is the Mavic Pro. I'm Ben from AuthenTech, and if you guessed it right, the Mavic Air is the one on the left and the Mavic Pro is on the right. Today we'll be doing a deep dive comparison of these two top tier, very similar drones. Which Mavic is best? So let's first start with the price tag. The new Mavic Air is $800 and the Mavic Pro is $1,000 or $200 more. Both come with a remote control, one battery, and just keep this pricing in mind as we proceed through all these tests. The Mavic Pro is about over 1 year old and $200 more. Now for our first comparison is a quick look at the size, weight, and portability. Both drones fold up quite small, though the Mavic Air just simply wins it. Now the Mavic Pro has and always felt super portable when folded up, which it still is, but when placed side by side with the Air, you can really see how impressively smaller the Air is while maintaining amazing specs and features, which I'll cover shortly. They're about the same width, and interesting enough, no, the Mavic Air's propellers do not fold in half like the Mavic Pro's, but thankfully they don't need to. Its overall body size is quite a bit shorter length than the Pro, and quite a bit shorter in height as well. As for weight, the Mavic Pro is 734 grams, the Air is only 430 grams. So yes, obviously the Mavic Air wins this one. Next quick comparison is battery life. The Mavic Air is rated to fly up to 21 minutes on a single charge. The Mavic Pro is rated up to 27 minutes, or about 6 minutes longer. I guess this is simply a benefit of larger body size. It can fit a larger battery, which the Mavic Pro wins this one. As for top speed, both are incredibly nimble and fun to fly in sport mode. Though I was very surprised with this one. The Mavic Air is rated for a faster top speed, up to 42.5 miles per hour, while the Mavic Pro is just slightly behind at 40.3 miles per hour. So the Mavic Air wins this one on the spec sheet, but they are very close. I ran a few speed tests and it had some interesting results. It was a pretty windy day and I'm impressed with how well they both could rip through the wind. Starting with the Mavic Pro, we hit a range of numbers with a headwind at 28, then 33, 34, and even a 37. There were some higher numbers, but I'm pretty sure those were ghost readings. When we jumped to the Mavic Air, I believe we clocked in 37 miles per hour both times. I would say overall pretty negligible, but both are fast, and again, when ripping around the air at these speeds, fly safe but have fun. And maybe I'll have to do another drone drag race video in the near future, maybe on a less windy day. You guys let me know down in the comments if you want to see that one. Last spec comparison before moving on to the cameras, the range of each of these drones is quite different. Max flight distance while maintaining a live video feed of 720p, this is key. The Mavic Air is rated up to 4 kilometers or about 2.5 miles away. The Mavic Pro is almost double that to 7 kilometers or 4.3 miles. So why such a big difference? Well, very interestingly, DJI decided to use two different technologies here. The Mavic Pro uses their amazing AccuSync transmission technology, while the Mavic Air is limited to using enhanced Wi-Fi. My two personal thoughts here. I would have loved to see them use AccuSync in the Mavic Air. It performs far better than Wi-Fi transmission. But number two, I have been a little impressed with the distance and FPV range I've been able to get so far with the Mavic Air, being only enhanced Wi-Fi. It's best when used in wide open areas, and it's far from perfect, though like in this shot, I was wrapping around to the tennis courts, the building was slightly in the way, and my FPV feed was glitching and bogging down pretty bad. You can see this in my screen capture. My distance was only 4 to 450 feet away, so this brings me to one of the biggest pros of the Mavic Pro over the Air. image transmission technology. It definitely wins this one hands down. I'm not saying the Mavic Air is always glitchy, nor is it a deal breaker, but this is one key area the Mavic Pro wins. While on that note of range, the remote controllers are very similar, all except for one glaring difference. The Mavic Pro has this nice convenient LCD screen built in. It shows you info like GPS, speed, and more. And I thought I'd greatly miss this on the Air since it doesn't have it, but the more I fly, I've learned that I survive just fine without it. I'm always connecting my phone anyway, so for me, it's not needed. Now for what you've all been waiting for, let's check out some really interesting and fun side-by-side camera comparison tests. All these shots were captured in auto, no post-processing applied. Here's some things you should notice right off the bat. A very, very cool feature that no one's talking about online is the camera's field of view. On the Mavic Pro, this was always one of my major biggest complaints. I felt the lens was a bit too narrow, while I liked my Phantom Advance for its wider angle. Well, maybe DJI heard my wishlist item in that video, and the Mavic Air has a wider field of view. The Mavic Pro is 78.8 degrees wide, or a 28mm lens equivalent. The Mavic Air is over 6 degrees wider, which might not sound like a lot, but it really clearly is, at 85 degrees or 24mm equivalent. As a little bonus tidbit, the Phantom Advance camera, which I've come to love, is actually a tad more narrow than the Mavic Air by just 1 degree at 84. This is great news for the Mavic Air being the widest. Now this is important because from my perspective, when I'm up in the air capturing those beautiful cinematic shots, I'm rarely or maybe almost never capturing objects super close up, right? I'm far back trying to squeeze in as much beautiful landscape into frame, or even let's say I'm racing after an electric scooter in my video. Being a single operator, flying drone, and trying to keep subject in center frame, this can be a difficult task, and a wider angle is going to help me with this while showing off the cool scenery that's all around. Now, of course, I'm not suggesting a fisheye with curved edges wide. That just looks terrible. But sticking with a focal length that's wide enough to capture those landscapes, but tight enough to still look cinematic, I think this is a great middle ground they found. Now, I'm intrigued. Do you agree with me or disagree? Do you want something tighter and more zoomed in? Let me know down below. Both cameras have the same sensor size, both have a 3-axis gimbal stabilizer for those buttery smooth shots. And on that quick note, it was somewhat windy on one of my film testing days, and I'd say the stability of flight and camera on both drones, even the smaller Mavic Air, were champs in the air. I thought with its smaller size, the Air would get pushed around a bit more, or maybe a bit harder to rip through the currents, but in my initial test scenes, it actually flew splendid. Actually, it was the Mavic Pro that I was surprised it seemed to have a little bit more wavering and tail wag when flying. Both cameras record 4K video at 30 frames per second. One major win that goes to the Mavic Air, it's actually recording a max video bitrate of 100 megabits per second versus the Mavic Pro is capped at 60. For being the smaller and cheaper drone, huge props to the DJI team for giving this huge feature to the Mavic Air. You should be able to notice this sometimes in image clarity and dynamic range. Now, when I compare the footage and photo side by side, it looks like the Mavic Air has a bit more contrast and saturation straight out of camera, which I'm actually digging. I like those rich colors, and even though the darks have a bit more contrast punch, I don't think it's too heavy. It still maintains shadow details. Even if we freeze frame and zoom way in, I'm very impressed with how well the Mavic Air competes. Most of the time, I would say it either looks the same or even better than the Mavic Pro. For being the more affordable drone, again, this is fantastic news if you're thinking about picking one up. As for still photography, both are capturing 12 megapixel photos. Again, they both take some really impressive and beautiful shots, but when zoomed way in, I personally have to give it to the Mavic Air for the crispier details, slightly better looking clarity, and it's managing contrast and colors better. The Mavic Pro often has this washed out, overexposed look. The Mavic Air has some cool new shooting modes and quick shots, one called Asteroid and the other Boomerang. They produce some really fun and cinematic looking shots. Another cool camera improvement the Mavic Air has over the Pro, it can shoot slow motion 120 FPS at 1080p. The Pro maxes out at 96 frames per second at 1080 or has to step down to 720 for the 120. One thing the Mavic Pro has is tap to focus, which can allow you to have a bit more narrow depth of field, blurred out backgrounds, that sort of thing. And the Mavic Air is simply infinity focus set. Now me personally, I actually really prefer the infinity focus. That way there's no more missed shots because I forgot to set the correct focus point on the Mavic Pro. That has happened to me before. It's just one less thing for me to think about or worry when flying. The Mavic Air has this new obstacle avoidance system that will supposedly intelligently auto-navigate around objects in its flight path. Stay tuned for me to test that out in depth. My Mavic Air review is coming soon. It also has rear-facing sensors for object avoidance. The Pro does not have this, only forward and downward facing, as does the Air. One last but small helpful new feature they place inside the Mavic Air is an onboard 8 gigs of storage to record your photos and video clips next time you leave the house without the micro SD card. Don't worry, I'm sure it'll happen to you soon. The Mavic Pro does not have this. So let's wrap this all up. Which Mavic drone is best? Which one should you buy? Well, the Mavic Air, which is currently $800, is 200 bucks cheaper than the Mavic Pro. I'd say the Air is better in almost all regards, which is just awesome if you think about it. It's smaller, more portable, and cheaper. The two biggest things I'll miss if I switch from the Mavic Pro is that better image transmission technology, further more clear image, and the slightly longer battery life. But I'll happily leave those behind for the new added features and benefits of the Mavic Air, not to mention that improved camera. If you guys haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe and bell icon to stay notified when I post my upcoming Mavic Air in-depth review versus Spark and other fun videos in the works. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, let's live authentic.